So, hi everybody. Just in the morning doing my artificial intelligence investigations, I was in Bing image search and noticed a feature they brought in. So let's just take this face. Obama. And actually, I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back to where I was before and show you just something here. Now, if we search within this image, we click it, you adjust the viewing data, let's say about like this, yeah. And so let's go up here. And the artificial intelligence algorithm of the Bing image recognition, data looks for patterns, makes comparisons. Using its algorithms, however they programmed it, and we can see on the right side here, it has found kind of stony patterns, some weavy patterns, some are fabric, some are stone. So it's taking it from the pattern, which is a very interesting feature. You see this is Coyote Butts, you know, it's a canyon. So this is actually a geological structure we're looking at. So when we take this here, we have these wonderful art prints, fabrics, patterns. That's what it sees. So you can see how the artificial intelligence is thinking based upon what data it's got and based upon what pattern and also the size. So here you can see it's got Coyote Butts. This is right, this is Coyote Butts. It's recognized it properly. But you might be an artist looking for fabric with this pattern, or you might be a person who wanted fabric with this pattern, or just like this pattern, and you're trying something. You're trying this painting. And so there's some very interesting features. But I haven't got, and this is very interesting. When we go here, look what happens. Women's hair. What does it see? Women's hair. What does it see now? Fabric. What happens when we put it here? Yeah, you can see it's looking at the textures. But this is a very abstract picture, okay? So we've seen how its artificial intelligence is what it's finding. Now let's look at facial recognition, which means we're going to go forward again to where I was, and we're going to take this picture of Obama, and we're going to search within this image using Bing artificial intelligence. This for sure is going to produce Obama. What I want to do is let's just play a little bit and go to a hand and see if it knows it's Obama's hand, which it doesn't. It'll tell you that it's not that good. It even brings a face. It's recognized just like, what do you call that when humans see something? Humans seeing, I've forgotten the word and I like to use it. What's it called again? Pareidolia. Pareidolia, apophenia. Apophenia. You look up apophenia, yeah? Interpret random image or patterns of light and shadow as faces. That's pareidolia. Apophenia is you see clusters of patterns in data inadvertently to prove your ideas, yeah? Apophenia is also, that means, for example, that you might look at a cloud. Let's do apophenia. Apophenia. This is a human phenomenon, yeah? Apophenia. So, for example, yeah, apophenia is here. You see a ram's horns in this image, right? Yeah? You see ram's horns. I see ram's horns, yeah? Apophenia. There's a joke about it. What is apophenia? Amazing, this pizza looks exactly like the brain scan of somebody who's experiencing apophenia. Abafina is when you take an abstract object like this, right? And your brain sees a face, Father Christmas in it or something. You ever looked at a tree and seen faces in the bark? It's called apophenia. Yeah? I'll just have a quick search within this image and see what Bing sees. Bing doesn't have apophenia with this. You see, apophenia is a human disease. It shouldn't be an artificial intelligence disease, should it? There's a very bad picture to try to prove that machines can have apophenia, but here we go. What do we have? Leaves. Let's go smaller. We've got butterflies. We've got dog bones, right? So the artificial intelligence is seeing butterflies and dog bones and leaves in this, right? What's it seeing here? Okay, it's seeing tiger spots, right? Okay, and so the artificial intelligence, let's go back now to the issue I wanted to talk about, because we're not just looking at how well artificial intelligence recognizes things and the fact that a minute ago when it was a bit higher, and now it's got horse's legs here. A minute ago it had a horse's face, if you remember, which I can't get back. There it is, not a horse's face, a human face, right? It's seen this face somehow in the curvature of this, analyzing the data pixel per pixel. The artificial intelligence of Bing image search is suffering apophenia, because in a picture of a hand, it's finding a picture of a face. So we're already showing that actually artificial intelligence can suffer the same things that we suffer, like apophenia, yeah, can make the same mistakes, or can imagine patterns, right, and see other things than what is actually being seen, right? No, go back. So here we have Obama. It's recognized his face, right? Let's now just go to his eyes. Can the artificial intelligence recognize Obama just from the eyes? Nope. This is what it's come up with. There's no Obama in there, right? Let's include his ear. Still no Obama. Thank God for that. From just a snippet of your eye and your ear, the IRS or the CIA or the FBI or some whichever hackers or mafia or whatever are not going to be able to find you with just that, using the artificial intelligence level of advancement that Bing image search has. So let's just look, see, what do we need to include? How much do we need to include of a face for it to become Obama? That's not Obama. So the artificial intelligence is now concentrating on where the most information is. That's definitely part of the algorithm. It's showing people with darker toned skin. Not always. We have a lighter person here. He's not fully the lightest skin in the world. Yeah, but it's also looking at the skin tone. And it's looking at the largest area here. It doesn't seem to be focusing on the ear at all. Or the eyes, because this guy isn't showing his eyes. And these eyes aren't very shown. This is a side view. You've got some eyes. It's placing some importance on the eyes. But it's obviously going from the center of the image and looking for where the greatest area scannable area is. So let's just go to his ear and one eye and take the hair out. No, okay, let's do his mouth. It's Obama. Do you need his ear? It's nearly Obama. Do you need his eyes? Nope. Still got him. So with a nose and a mouth, or eyes and a nose. You don't get Obama with eyes and a nose, but you get it with a nose and a mouth. And there you go. Facial recognition is advancing. And I have to stop this recording because I'm not allowed more than 10 minutes. See you later. So a quick look at artificial intelligence image search. This is using Bing. Search within this image. As you can see, if I click there, it's going to find loads of pictures of Obama. Let's just look at his hand and let's see if looking at Obama's hand is enough for the artificial intelligence to know it's Obama. No, it doesn't. But it sees a face. Sees a face here. See the face? Why does it see a face? In this? Because the artificial intelligence is suffering apophenia. What is apophenia? Apophenia is the tendency to perceive a meaningful pattern between unrelated or random things, such as objects or ideas. Apophenia means when you look at something, you might see here, somebody say, oh, there's Jesus's face in this pancake, right? Okay, apophenia is abstract patterns. The human brain tends to look for orderliness in disorder, and it will imagine shapes and faces and all sorts of things in there. So apophenia is an effect of human brain, yeah? Apophenia, seeing things in other things. You look at something and you think it looks like something else, right? Okay. You know, like ink blots, you know? Ink blots. You know these ink blots. Oh, it's a butterfly. Oh, it's two fish looking at each other. Yeah? This is apophenia. So, go back to Obama. Get to his face. You see that's his face. Click again. It knows it's Obama. Now, until they're going to use this technology to find you, what do they need? Your eyes and your head? No, it's not even focusing on the eyes very much. Some are on the eyes, some are on the head. Let's take the eyes out and just the head. You've got all sorts of things here. So, put just the ear. Does it know it's Obama from his ear? No, it doesn't. And it's got apophenia because it sees a shoe as well. So artificial intelligence, not only living humans, suffer apophenia. Right? Now let's take his eyes and his nose just a little bit wider, like this. His eyes and his nose. Is that enough to get Obama? No, still not enough. So let's take his nose and his mouth. Is that enough to get Obama? Well, there's an Obama in here. There's an Obama. And why is it getting Trump there? It's getting Trump. And Obama and similar. But what do you, if you do the eyes and the nose and the face, and the eyes, nose, and the mouth, you got Obama. You take his mouth out, You got Obama. You take his nose in his mouth. You got some Obama. Nearly Obama, but not Obama. So that's how far the facial recognition has gone. In the next podcast, I'll take an abstract picture and show you some useful things. But with this one, I just wanted to prove that artificial intelligence can suffer apophenia, and to show you just how far Bing's facial image recognition has gone. Yeah, but that with this shape, we already got a human face seen by Bing, which proves that Bing suffers apophenia. Here it is, the human face here. And I have to stop this recording because I'm using a free recorder which only allows 10 minutes. So that was artificial intelligence image recognition and association with the image data, and proof of the fact that artificial intelligence machines, machine learning, can suffer apophenia, and in fact needs to suffer apophenia to be able to find things. But apophenia has not been deliberately programmed into the algorithm. So I think I might share this with Microsoft. And I'm definitely going to share this with all of you, so you start to understand the many applications of artificial intelligence, the dangers, the worrisome things, and the beauty of it as well, because it can do some beautiful things. And I think I'm going to upload this to my webmaster channel. So I'll sign off as Ajahn Spencer for the webmaster channel. Signing off.